Grandmaster Ivan Cheparinov is unstoppable as he moves to round 5 with a 100% score. He joins us in our studio. Ivan, 4 out of 4, you're on fire.
Yeah, I think this is my best start here in Gibraltar, by far, I think.
What do you think is working for you?
Okay, for the moment, Greenfield, obviously, because I'm winning only Greenfield here.
From both colors.
Right, yeah, so I think it's just this opening maybe suits me. So.
Yeah. Today, at this moment after rook e8, things seemed to go according to plan. e5 yeah. Looks very difficult for black
it's
already.
It's very typical e5. This is a very famous plan and many strong players won by this. For example, Carson won similar games. The idea is that just this bishop is very bad, the king is very bad. And at some point, knight g3 and... okay, I cannot mate. But knight g3, bishop f6, queen g5, knight h5, just mate. Or king f2, rook h1. So there are many plans and black doesn't have anything because there is no counterplay.
So after e5, your idea is just to checkmate black's
king?
Yeah,
I was pretty sure that here is just over the game because he doesn't have any constructive plan. I mean, he can play everything, but there's no way to escape from the mating attack. So.
Should he have fought this plan maybe instead of rook f8?
Yeah, rook e8 probably is bad. Maybe he should play rook c4 or f5 immediately, but still the position I think is very unpleasant. Maybe the computer will save it, but...
It looks very shaky for
from
black.
From a practical point of view, I guess it's very difficult for black. Yeah. That's why I think he played rook e8 because he panicked probably. Because otherwise you never play rook e8. Because he was thinking for 7 minutes and played rook e8. So maybe he was just not sure about his position, you know.
And after e5, you actually went on to successfully deliver mate on black. Is there absolutely nothing that black could have done
actually,
to create
play? Actually,
he played
f6 himself, so here is just finished. But he could play, for example, I calculated this line. Rook h1, it was very interesting line. Rook c2, bishop f6. Now the whole point is that if you take and queen e5, I have this very unpleasant check.
Rook h8. Oh, this is...
Yeah,
this is the
whole trick of... Okay, bishop f6 of course is not necessary, but I mean this is the first line that I wanted to play because it's just immediately mate. And if you maybe take here doesn't help because take, for example, g5 rook here, and it just
falls apart.
So I think this is the only line that I needed to calculate because, okay, bishop f6 is not necessary, but it's just very strong. I don't see how to stop it, I just want to give mate.
And this final position is... quite
beautiful. Here I think I'm winning with so many things. I can take there, I can play even knight f4 maybe mate. So I mean there's so many checks here that it was clear that it's just winning.
Right, and so the main point of e5 was actually to trade off black's defensive dark square bishop on g7
yes,
and then...
To block the bishop and black doesn't have any counterplay and then just to continue with rook h1 or queen f4, there are many different plans. Even some point maybe knight g3, knight e4 or knight h5.
And bishop f6 ideas
yes,
are always
bishop
there.
Bishop f6 or bishop h6, it's very unpleasant.
Very unpleasant. All right, well, 4 out of 4, feeling good?
Yeah, of course. But just started, so it's nothing so dramatically.
It's a good start. And like you said yesterday when you were with us, that you would love to come back here every day and give us an interview.
Yeah, and I thought I would like to show some groom food, but I didn't expect that I would be white. So.
With both colors.
Yes, yes.
Well, we wish you all the best for the remaining rounds, and we look forward to having you back again.
Thanks.
Thank you, Ivan.